This is Audio Footlights, a behind-the-scenes podcast presented by the Children's Theater of Cincinnati. This podcast was created to take a closer look into the shows we produce, to inspire, impact, and ignite a lifelong love of theater. This episode of Audio Footlights focuses on our production of Disney and Pixar's Finding Nemo Jr. My name is Aaron Marshall, and I play Marlin in this production. With me today is Tommy Harsh, who plays Dory in the show. Please welcome to the podcast, Tommy.
Hello.
Okay, what got you started in theater, and how old were you when you started?
That is a great question. So I was very into singing and things at my school and at my church growing up. And I did my first musical when I was 11. I was in Children of Eden with the East Side Players at like an outdoor amphitheater, local community theater. I was in the ensemble and I got to do a part in the Lake Snake.
Okay.
Oh yeah, I was super hyped.
That's awesome.
And what about
you? That's great. I too got started in church musicals, kinda. My mom signed me up for it and I didn't even ask. And and she was like, this is something you can do. And then I ended up falling in love with it and, you know, pursued it for my life. I was like 9 or 10. So around the same age.
When you know, you know.
Yeah, exactly. What are you most excited for audiences to see in Finding Nemo Jr.?
Honestly, I think the combination of the puppetry and the set, it is just going to be such a visual spectacle. I've been so impressed throughout this entire rehearsal process with how everybody is doing with the puppetry, especially for some folks where maybe that's not their first and best skill. Mm-hmm. So I think that is just going to grip the audiences, especially for the little audience members. I think they are just going to be like jaws to the floor the whole time. Uh-huh. And what would you say?
That's a hard question, but right now I'm kind of thinking of, I'm excited for people to hear the music of this show because it really has good music and there's so many through lines and connections to other songs the more you listen to it. And it's also exciting to see this is like one of the only Disney production that is brought to this stage that originally didn't have music. So it was added after the fact. And it creates for a really special show, I think.
Mm-hmm. I would agree.
Okay, you played some pretty iconic roles at TCT, including Mrs. Honey in Matilda the Musical and Sandy Cheeks in the SpongeBob Musical. Is there a dream role that you haven't played yet?
You know what? That's a hard question because I have been very lucky to play many roles that I absolutely adore, but I would say I've never been able to do Ariel in The Little Mermaid, and that is like, I just would flip my lid if I got to play that part.
This show was all about the puppets. Did you find it difficult to act, sing, you know, be a triple threat, control the puppet at the same time?
Straight answer, yes. Like, yes, no fooling, no jokes about it. It is difficult. I feel like I'm finding myself focusing so much more, and I'm sure you would agree, like on the voice acting aspect of it, I guess in a way it's sort of a cool tribute to the film because that obviously is all voice acting.
Yeah.
So this, I think in that way, it has been a really cool challenge. That is, and I've had so many people ask me that too. They're like, wow, with puppets, what's that like? I'm like, hard.
It's hard.
It's hard, but it's cool.
But rewarding.
Yeah.
What lessons do you think can be learned from this story in Finding Nemo Jr.?
My first thought with that question, I would say, is persistence and commitment to those in your life that you love and trust. Trusting in the people around you and having faith in them to accomplish what they believe that they can do.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think it is interesting because it is such a childhood sort of like nostalgic thing. I think like you and I probably both grew up watching it.
That.
And as a kid, you take away so many different things, but as an adult looking at the story, you're like, oh, this is
two different stories.
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, there's Nemo. And when you're a kid, you're relating to Nemo. And when you get older, you relate to the parents and like the other people. And it's so different.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why it's so amazing how Pixar both makes movies for those demographics. Like, there's like the different things that you can take from it.
Yeah.
Okay, now it is time for what we call the lightning round, where I'll ask Tommy as many questions as I can in under a minute. Ready, set, go. What is your favorite color?
Yellow.
What is your favorite holiday?
4th of July.
What's your favorite dream vacation destination?
Right now, I would say Italy.
If you lived in the ocean, what animal would you be?
A dolphin.
Tacos or pizza?
Ooh, pizza.
What is your favorite animal?
A cat right now.
What is your favorite cartoon?
That's a really hard question. I say a movie cartoon?
Sure,
The Incredibles.
Okay. If you could have any superpower, what would it be?
Apparating.
Apparating?
Yeah, being able to like go from one place to like in Harry Potter where they like go.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You know, I mean, that's technically like a spell, but like I would make it a superpower.
Oh, for sure. What's your favorite movie?
Footloose, the original. The remake was terrible.
Yes. Last question. What is your favorite musical?
Spring Awakening.
Ooh. Thank you for joining us for Audio Footlights. If you want to learn more about the world of theater, visit thechildrenstheater.com to hear about classes and upcoming shows. Until next time, thank you for listening to TCT's Audio Footlights.